The following program may contain scenes of violence and is not suitable for everyone. Viewer discretion is advised.
We have a great night of action here at the Oshawa Legion Hall.
The fans are going wild. Everyone here in Oshawa is ready for this huge event.
Well, it's been dubbed Civil War, and the PWE Flame Championship is on the line. Jules Malone against newcomer Casey Spinelli.
I cannot wait for this one, the Flame Championship.
And a 2 out of 3 falls match. These two guys do not like each other. Will White goes one-on-one with Tyson Duke.
But will we see Bill Black? That's the question.
Well, another question that needs to be answered is who will be the Fusion champion after tonight? Tyler Tirva goes one-on-one once again with all ego, Ethan Page. And starting out the night, here we go. A little unorthodox tag team here in Jim Nye, the Science Guy, and Buck Gunderson. They decided to join forces.
This team has lots of promise.
And they're being dubbed the Science Bucks tonight. I like that sign.
These two could go far in PWE, that's what I think.
Well, they've definitely made quite the name for themselves over the past few months here on PWE on Rogers TV. Let's see if they can do it again tonight. Oh, and who is this in the front row? I believe that's Jamie Virtue, well-known manager in the wrestling biz. What's he doing here, Andrew?
I have no idea, but he looks interested in the PWE wrestlers here tonight.
You don't have anything to do with this? You didn't invite him here?
I had nothing to do with this at all.
All right. Well, either way, it looks like he might be scouting some talent here tonight. Starting out with a pretty crazy tag team here. The combination of Jim Nye and Buck Gunderson rubbing his head for some good luck.
Weighing in at a total combined weight of 443 pounds, the team of John Atlas and Bill Atlas, the Atlas Cousins.
Well, the Atlas Cousins are working together tonight. They had a little friendly competition last time we saw them here, but looks like they put their differences aside. The Cousins are going to work together.
Absolutely, Sal. Blood is thicker than water, and this family is ready to go here tonight.
Well, it's Team Atlas, the Atlases, or the Atli, I don't know, whatever you want to call them. One of them is the TV champ in John Atlas. He beat Tarek a couple months back. Tarek hasn't been seen ever since.
Playboy ran him out of town.
Here comes Phil Atlas, the veteran of the two. Quite skilled in the ring. He's wrestled all over the world. Bringing his talents here to Oshawa tonight, once again to PWE on Rogers TV. We're happy to have him.
And these two cousins, they've been wrestling around since they were kids in their grandma's house.
That's right, last time they mentioned they used to wrestle in their grandma's living room. They grew up together in the wrestling biz. And now they're teaming up, a little rock, paper, scissors with their competition. Who's gonna start in the ring? Looks like it's Buck Gunderson.
They are a very unorthodox team, but I like them.
Well, let's see what they bring here to the table here tonight.
They have some real stiff competition here in the Atlases.
And it looks like Buck is going to start things off with Bill Atlas.
Or no, he might not. As per usual here in Oshawa, they start chanting that science sucks, much to the chagrin of Jim Nye.
Jim Nye doesn't like that one bit.
There you go, Buck. Don't let him hear it. Science doesn't suck.
Great tag team working together already before the match even starts. They have each other's back. This could be the new tag team sensation here in PWE. Buck Gunderson lost the rock, paper, scissors. He's this match underway. Bell rings.
What an amazing night we do have in store.
Well, I forgot to mention with the main event tonight, it is All Ego Ethan Page and Tyler Tirva once again, except that Commissioner Adam Hayes is going to be handcuffed to the guardrail. No shenanigans from Hayes tonight.
No, he will not be able to do anything, and I am really looking forward to that matchup. Two of the best in the world going at it here in Oshawa.
Well, let's see how Tyler Tirva can fare without the help of Adam Hayes. And this match is getting started. One kick from Phil Atlas. These two are ready to go. Lock him in the center of the ring. Phil Atlas has him by the arm. He brings Buck down to the mat.
What a contrast in styles between these two.
Absolutely.
Old school brawler in Gunderson versus the style and the finesse of the Atlas brothers, excuse me, the Atlas cousins.
They're cousins, let's not forget. And the tag has been made to Jim Nye the Science Guy. He's focused, he's ready. Oh. Quick arm drag there from Phil Atlas. Brings him down to the mat right away. Drops the knee onto his arm. Keeping it wrenched. Phil Atlas keeping him in the Atlas's corner.
And one more time. Ow!
You see, obviously Jim Nye is in quite a bit amount of pain here. As John Atlas is tagged into this match, going up top, working the arm. Jim Nye, the science guy.
This is not a good start for the science bucks.
Can science prevail here tonight? That is the question. I believe I hear Buck chanting science rules, trying to counteract this audience here, who always chants science sucks. In the Oshawa Legion Hall, they are not fans of science. I'll tell you, they are fans of TV champ John Atlas.
Oh, what a drop kick.
And the cousins Atlas putting on a clinic here so far. Quick tag made to Phil back into the ring. Off the ropes, comes back. Cousin John launching him into the air, and a huge splash goes for the cover.
Amazing style.
And no, Jim Nye manages to get the kick out after two. And again, you'll notice they're doing a good job of keeping him in their corner, keeping him isolated from his partner, Buck Gunderson. Once again, oh no, Jim Nye has Phil Atlas by the ear, brings him into the corner, ref was giving him the count, misses the punch, and Phil Atlas is going back to work.
Knife edge chop from Phil.
Big uppercut there. Nice elbow.
Jim Nye looks dazed.
Little reversal.
For science!
And not for science. Phil Atlas going up top. Jim Nye managed to squeeze out of that one. Jim Nye down on the mat again. And another huge splash.
Every time it looks like Nye's coming back. Oh no, Phil!
Phil always has the answer, and that is the veteran expertise of Phil Atlas. Oh, and a tag. He didn't seem to be expecting that one from his cousin, John Atlas.
I don't think Phil was ready to come out of the ring.
And here it is. A little competition between the cousins once again, getting the best of them.
We have seen this animosity before.
You think Phil Atlas is a little jealous, maybe his cousin John? You know, at the top of his game here in PWE as the TV champ.
Oh, there's Buck Gunderson.
Oh, and Buck.
The referee wasn't looking.
And Buck taking advantage. Here goes Jim Nye with the cover. A little slow to the cover. Let's see how he does. No, a kick out after one. Didn't do enough there. Getting choked up on the ropes by Buck Gunderson when the ref didn't see him. And now Buck makes the blind tag. Oh. Headbutt to the midsection of John Atlas.
This is is their chance. This is the turning point in the match right here.
The comeback. And Phil must be not too pleased. John makes the tag. Gets in the ring, and now this is happening to him. Face being dragged across the top rope into the corner. And there's Gunderson.
Buck Gunderson with that headbutt.
Using his head as a weapon. We've seen that many times from Buck Gunderson. And now these two seem to be working together as a well-oiled machine. The Science Bucks going to work.
Nice quick tags.
I can only imagine Phil Atlas is none too pleased right now. He had this match in control until the TV champ John Atlas got in there.
And they are isolating him.
And things are looking good for Nye.
Big elbow
Gunderson.
Drop.
Nice elbow drop.
Oh, going for the tag.
Couldn't make the reach there. Jim Nye goes for the cover, but no. John Atlas manages to kick out after two. Wrench in the arm. Buck making another quick tag. These two seem to have found their flow together as a tag team. Working out well for them. Once again, Buck Gunderson using his head as a weapon, not letting John get the tag to his cousin Phil. Driving John's head into the mat, and another quick tag to Jim Nye.
Just amazing teamwork.
These two are flowing so well. And a huge boot by Jim Nye, the Science Guy, going for the cover once again. And no, TV champ John Atlas manages to get to the rope. Oh, and a huge slap by Phil Atlas, who's not the legal man.
Jim Nye
was just making sure he stayed out of the ring. And now John Atlas doing everything he can.
DDT.
Huge DDT. Jim Nye on the defense there makes the tag once again to Buck Gunderson.
Quick cover.
And John Atlas was just trying to make a tag. Jim Nye did a good job of preventing that from happening. And now Buck Gunderson's in the ring going to work on the TV champ.
Seeing some serious aggression here
from
Jim Nye and Buck Gunderson.
Drove his face into his tag team partner's boot. Tag is made once again, but John Atlas is starting to fight back. But these two seem to have the answer for everything that John Atlas comes up with. Driving shoulder into the midsection, into the corner. John Atlas seems hopeless right now.
I don't even know how the Playboy's still holding on. Here
he
comes.
Blocks the punch, making a comeback with these punches.
He's taking both of them out.
John Atlas seems to be getting back into this match finally. Going to work on Jim Nye, the Science Guy. Off the ropes, comes back. Huge double clothesline, and both men are taken down on the mat. Who will take advantage in this tag team match? It's been hard fought, a good effort by both teams.
John Atlas has been in a bad way for a while now. This is his chance to make the tag to his cousin.
Well, it looks like both men are slowly crawling to their corners to make the tag to their respective partners. Both of their partners, Buck and, Phil Atlas.
What?
He was reaching out for the tag and he pulled his hand away at the last second.
Oh my God.
Not letting his cousin tag out of this match.
What?
John Atlas can't believe it. Buck Gunderson got the tag and now he's in this match. And a little bit of double team action here from the Science Bucks. Huge backbreaker and Buck Gunderson's up
here
on the top.
Here goes Buck.
Oh man.
Gunderson
going for the cover here, and that's it.
They did it.
The Science Bucks win this match, all because Phil Atlas refused to make the tag to his cousin.
I can't believe it.
Win here. I don't think anybody can believe it. Buck Gunderson and Jim Nye are the victors over the Atlas cousins, all because Phil didn't want to be a tag team partner in the end.
What a huge win for Gunderson and Nye here in PWE.
What a huge upset for the TV champ, John Atlas. His cousin seemed to turn his back on him, and now he's holding the TV title.
But what? Why did Phil do this? I don't understand. I guess he wants the title.
I don't know. Well, maybe a little bit of jealousy is playing into this, as I was saying before, but these two seem to have had their problems for the past few months. And now Phil Atlas is holding the TV title. It looks like he may have stated his case that he should be next in line for the TV championship.
I guess blood isn't thicker than water.
after nearly 2 years of completely dominating competition, Will White has succumbed to a pinfall by Tyson Deuce. Shoulders on the mat, 1, 2, 3. Defeated. How's defeat taste? Tastes like sour apples, doesn't it? Terrible. And look at this. Eclipse has decided that maybe that was a fluke. And so maybe one time isn't enough, and then maybe the second time is not enough. So 2 out of 3 falls, this is what we're doing today. This is what they decided at Eclipse, is we'll put the two mythical beasts together. Will White being the flaming phoenix. Huh? Tyson Dukes being like a piranha mixed with a rhino. What do you call that? A piranha? Rhyana? It doesn't matter. The end result is the bird dies at the end of this film. Welcome to my show. It's the Eclipse Show featuring Tyson Dukes. That's a wrap.
Well, strong words from Tyson Dukes. We've got a lot to say about his match with Will White later tonight, but coming to the ring right now, newcomer to PWE, KC Spinelli, with former Flame champion Kaitlin Diamond. And she's going to have a match for the Flame championship tonight against Jules Malone.
I've heard of KC Spinelli. Everyone loves this girl. She's big time. She's got style, and now she's with Kaitlin Diamond, who has a different style. We haven't seen her looking like that yet in PWE.
Well, a new attitude from former Flame champion Kaitlin Diamond. Been hanging out with KC Spinelli a little too much, I think. That's all going to come to a head after the break, because KC Spinelli is going one-on-one with Jules Malone. And instead, that match is up next. The Flame Championship is on the line.
Rage, you have fallen once before, and tonight, you will fall for not only the 10 count, but you will fall once and for all.
How did he even get on the show? He doesn't even have a shirt on. What a maniac.
Well, what are the boys in the truck doing? How did that even get on the show? I have no idea.
Jesse Amato's crazy.
He must have hacked into the system or something somehow. But anyways, we're back at the Oshawa Legion Hall inside, where PWE Flame Champion Jules Malone is making her way to the ring. Been the defending Flame champion for a few months here in PWE. Successful title run for her. And she has a big opponent tonight. A newcomer to PWE, but not a newcomer to the wrestling scene in Canada, KC Spinelli. Who had some choice words for the audience here during the commercial break.
Well, Jules Malone has her work cut out for her, that's for sure. KC Spinelli, not liked here in Oshawa because of her comments, but she still does have some fans in the crowd. It'll be interesting to see how Jules Malone handles an opponent like her.
Well, what about the factor of Kaitlin Diamond and KC Spinelli seem to be buddies, and Kaitlin Diamond's going to be a ringside for this match. Could that come into effect?
It sure could, and it's a whole new Kaitlin Diamond. We haven't seen this side of her ever.
Well, I believe Kaitlin Diamond spent some time in Japan. Maybe she picked up this new attitude during her time there. KC Spinelli, one of the great Canadian women wrestlers on the indie scene today. Could she be the new face of the PWE women's division?
Hey, I'd be totally fine with that.
A little high five from her new pal, Kaitlin Diamond. And they're trying to start a new chant. Trying to start a new chant to counteract this hardcore chant.
Come on, Oshawa. You got to chant international.
That's right. These two are claiming that they're international stars. They have wrestled all over the world. But it all counts right here in Oshawa, where the Flame Championship is on the line. And the fans have much love. Hardcore Princess Jules Malone. She is their defending Flame champion. KC Spinelli taking her time to get in the ring. Taking some time to chirp the fans.
Yeah, she's just playing mind games, but I guess it's really not working. Jules Malone knows what's going on.
Yeah, she thinks she's crazy, and she might be. A little pep talk from her pal, Kaitlin Diamond. Telling her to give her a sec. She's not ready for this match to begin just yet.
Well, she's got to get rid of her gum.
Don't tell me.
Oh,
that's disgusting. That is gross. I know these two are friends, but come on.
It's the mark of a true team, Sal. They're close.
Apparently so. All right, well, Casey Spinelli claiming that she's going to be the new Flame champion after tonight. Holding that belt up.
She's an international superstar.
And that's what it's all about, folks. And this match is ready to go, it looks like. Finally, Casey Spinelli is in the ring.
Well, this is big time. This is important. Casey Spinelli is in a PWE ring, and the match will start when she wants it to start.
Well, already. I mean, the ref was asking Jules if she was ready to go, but she was already distracted by Kaitlin Diamond on the outside of the ring. So as I said, this has already kind of taken a factor here.
See, she has some fans here in Oshawa. Chanting Casey Rocks.
And now here come the hardcore chants for Jules Malone. And that's what it's all about. Hashtag PWE Flame Championship. It is on the line right now. Once again, Jules Malone is defending her title.
This has a big fight feel to it. This is a huge Flame Championship match.
Absolutely.
One of the biggest we've seen here in PWE.
Two of the greats in women's Canadian wrestling. Casey Spinelli. We got to do her pre-match stretch. Taking some time right now to do that in the beginning of this matchup. Circling each other, here they go, ready to lock up once again. No. And look at that. Jules Malone dominates right off the top. Jules Malone.
She's got that wrist.
Drops her down to the mat, and Casey Spinelli rolls out of the ring. And Jules Malone takes some time to taunt. Casey Spinelli looks like she's hurt already.
Not the start she wanted.
The ref's starting the count. Casey Spinelli wants this match to continue. She better get back into the ring. She's taking the time to take a drink.
Yeah, she needs to replenish, rehydrate.
A little cold pop on the outside.
I think she just stole that guy's pop.
I don't think she cares. And she's taking a breather.
Probably sell that pop on eBay.
Ah, jeez. And Jules Malone going for the chase on the outside. Casey Spinelli back of the ring, trips over the middle rope and face plants. Aren't you embarrassed in the roll up? And once again, the backslide here, going for it.
Oh
and
no.
Another cover, this could be it. Quickly, no. Casey Spinelli got out of that pin. And another roll up
another
once
one.
Again. And that's it after two. She manages to get out of that. And Casey Spinelli outside of the ring once again. Her pal Kaitlin Diamond fanning her off.
Yeah, she just needs to regroup again. It's all right.
As I said in the first match, it's a little hot here inside the Oshawa Legion Hall. It is the summertime after all. Oh!
Big forearm.
Wow. That was phenomenal. And Jules Malone is going to go for a suicide dive through the middle ropes. Casey Spinelli answered with the forearm. And now Casey Spinelli seems to be in control outside of the ring. And will Kaitlin Diamond come into effect here? We'll just have to see. People were chanting hardcore before, and this one's still outside the ring.
Face first onto the apron.
Ouch. And Casey Spinelli slid back in the ring for a quick second, breaking up the count. Taking her time to get champion Jules Malone back into the ring. And now the action will continue for the PWE Flame Championship. Oh. A little bit of taunting here from choking out the champion in the corner. And the ref saw none of it. There we go. A little bit of acrobatics here. And a drop kick to the face of the champion in the cover. No.
KC Spinelli regrouping twice on the outside. And it seemed to work. It turns out it was all strategy.
And this strategy may have worked in her favor. She's now in control of this match over the PWE Flame Champion. Oh. I heard that chop back here. There's her friend Kaitlin Diamond cheering her on from the outside. She got involved in the action. Oh.
I don't even call that cheating. She's just taking advantage of having a friend out there.
Here comes a little spinneroony head scissors. And there it is. Oh,
wow.
Man. Nicely done by Flame Champion.
Maybe we need a Malone section.
The other side of the ring. Well, that was quite the spin from Malone. Oh, nice clothesline to take down the champ. Knocked the wind right out of her.
She's having a hard time breathing, that's for sure.
And she just passed her a beer? Oh,
is that what that was?
And the cover. Took a second to regroup. Swig a beer.
What a different Kaitlin Diamond this is.
Yeah, we haven't seen this Kaitlin Diamond before in PWE. As I said, it's been a few months since we've seen her, and she is a changed woman. Oh, and a huge punch from the champion saying, let's go. Don't count Jules Malone out of this one yet.
Oh.
Trading blows back and forth. Getting hyped up by the crowd. Casey Spinelli has the answer.
Smelly's fighting back.
These two are going at it with the forearms.
Jules Malone getting the best of Casey Spinelli.
Backing her up into the corner. Shoulder to the midsection. Going to the other side. Comes charging at her. Huge uppercut. What's she going for here? Nice little flip over the top. Into a cutter, goes for the cover. Casey Spinelli manages to kick out after two.
And the international star is still alive.
Crowd chanting hardcore. It's all about Jules Malone, the PWE Flame Champion.
She's got her set up.
Oh, wow. Nice suplex there. Goes for the cover. Once again, no. Casey Spinelli kicks out after two. This match is still going. What's it going to take for Jules Malone to retain the championship? What's it going to take for Casey Spinelli to get back in this?
And will Kaitlin Diamond get involved again?
So many questions to be answered here to come in this match. And we're sticking with this one to the end.
Here comes Spinelli. She's got her.
Spinelli's coming back.
Clothesline.
Huge spinning clothesline there.
Kaitlin Diamond's happy about that one.
Once again, is this the time? And the cover, no. She took some time to taunt the crowd once again, and she can't believe it that she didn't get the three count. She seems very unhappy with that.
I mean, it was kind of a lackluster pin, but give her points for style.
Here we go, a little reverse DDT maybe. Oh, and Jules Malone got out of that one. What's she going for here?
Oh, no. This isn't good for Casey Spinelli. She's taking her for a ride. Oh,
no.
And
she has it locked in. And there she goes. She grabbed her by the neck.
No, don't, Casey. Don't.
Is she going to tap out? And that is it.
Ah, come on.
Casey Spinelli taps out. Jules Malone retains the Flame Championship once again in another hard-fought match. The international superstar couldn't do it.
And if Casey Spinelli couldn't do it, I don't know who can.
Well, what a dominant run by Jules Malone here in PWE thus far. What an effort by the international superstar Casey Spinelli. But Jules Malone is still your Flame
Tyson Dukes has lost his mind. Tyson Dukes has lost his mind. 2 out of 3 falls match. Tyson, you're walking around here congratulating yourself, patting yourself on your back because you pinned me. The odds were stacked against me, and you pinned me. Tonight, Tyson, 2 out of 3 falls match. They say all bad things come in threes. Well, I have a feeling that tonight, the wrestling machine Tyson Dukes plus Will White equals. Push, and he pushes back. Tonight, 2 out of 3 falls match. He's coming.
And that match is coming up next. Will White in a 2 out of 3 falls match with Tyson Dukes.
But will we see Bill Black? Stick around and we'll find out.
Let me tell you how I feel about Joshua James. Joshua James wants to jump me from behind in a locker room and try to take me out and end my career. How would you feel about that? I'm riding up and down the roads just trying to feed my family, and he tries to end my career. I have a message for you folks out there in TV land watching this on Rogers TV Durham. And listen closely, Joshua James. Put the women and the children to bed, because you are not going to want to witness what the Deaner is about to do.
Well, Cody Deaner is always amped up, but I don't think we've ever seen him this emotional before.
Well, it's definitely personal between him and Joshua James. Joshua James took him out last November, and he missed a title opportunity because of that. That match is coming up later, but right now we have the 2 out of 3 falls match, and on his way to the ring is the wrestling machine, Tyson Dukes.
Tyson Dukes, a veteran.
Absolutely. He's been around the indie circuit for a long time here in Canada, and he's made a name for himself in the last few months in PWE. And it is also personal between Will White and Tyson Dukes as well, and it's going to come to a blow here tonight.
Will White, he can't wait to get his hands on Tyson Dukes. And this match should be outstanding. 2 out of 3 falls.
Absolutely, these are two of the best that PWE has on its roster. And the fans are certainly in for a treat with this match tonight.
That's right, Dukes is a wrestling machine.
Introducing his opponent, about to make his way ringside from Pickering, Ontario, weighing 196 pounds, give it up for Will.
Bill Black, whatever you want to call him, he is ready to go. Him and Tyson Dukes do not like each other. And they're certainly going to find out who the better man is here tonight. In 2 out of 3 falls action, PWE on Rogers TV.
I mean, the fans love him here in Oshawa, but this guy's a maniac as well. You never know what you're going to get. Tyson Dukes, he's a wrestling machine, but he has his hands full with this guy right here.
Absolutely. Former PWE heavyweight champion, Will White, was on top for a very long time here in PWE on Rogers TV. And Tyson Dukes had a lot to do with his downfall.
Now look at him. He's already losing his mind.
Oh, man. We could see Bill Black early on here tonight. Crowd definitely wants to see it.
It's 2 out of 3 falls, but it's 2-on-1 as well. Tyson Dukes has to wrestle 2 men.
Oh, man. Fans are chanting, let him out. Don't egg him on. He may go crazy early on in this match here tonight. Oh, and Tyson Dukes, before the bell rings, he's not going to let it happen.
Taking advantage of the craziness.
Well, Will White was a little distracted on the top, and now Tyson Dukes is taking advantage. Maybe that's the veteran expertise.
something for the wrestling machine. That's how you do it. Will White is none too happy, and I don't blame him.
First fall, Tyson Dukes leads 1-0.
Well, one more pin from Tyson Dukes, and this match is over. Jeez, if we thought Will White was angry when the match started, he must be furious right now. Jamie Virtue in the front row there. He seems pretty impressed with Tyson Dukes' effort here. He's on his feet. Well, he doesn't seem to understand what the audience is chanting here right now. He's about to see what Will White is made of because he is angry. Tyson Dukes keeping his distance, and I can't say I blame him right now.
And of course he's impressed with the wrestling machine. I don't think Will White's ever been covered that quickly in any match ever in PWE.
Well, when he was the champion, he was dominant for over a year, undefeated. Tyson Dukes handed him his first loss. And now he pinned him very quickly into this match, so I can understand where Will White's frustration is coming from. Tyson Dukes getting back into the ring, but Will White, he's basically saying, are you sure you want to do this? Do you want to step into the ring with the maniac? All right, and now the referee keeps the distance between the two men, and the second fall of this match can begin.
But a huge early advantage for Tyson Dukes.
Will White's clearly not all there. Our hashtag for this match is White versus Dukes. We may have to change that hashtag shortly, depending on what happens with Will White. What goes on inside that head of his?
I don't think anyone knows what's going on in there.
Tyson Dukes is rolling out.
Try to get out of it.
Down
nope.
The mat. Will White's wrenching the arm there. Can the wrestling machine get out of this hold?
Now Will White wearing down Dukes.
Both of these men very technical inside the ring. Tyson Dukes rolls out of it, gets him in a head scissors, gets out of that hold, and now he's taking the advantage.
There's the skill of the wrestling machine.
Absolutely. Tyson Dukes is a veteran of the game. And he's showing that right now.
Now a reversal from White.
Well, White takes him down to the mat for the quick cover. No, Tyson Dukes gets out after one, and both of these men are back to their feet.
Nice little back and forth exchange between the two, but now Will White laughing as he usually does.
These two are gonna lock up in the center, no. Will White with that arm lock. Even let the tie-up happen.
Crowd here in Oshawa wants Will White to let him out. I say keep him in.
I don't think that's going to be good for business, Andrew. A little reversal here from Will White. Now a reversal from Tyson Dukes. Very technical between these two. As I was saying, both very skilled. A technical and mat-based wrestling, and they're showcasing that here in this match tonight.
Very back and forth between the two.
Absolutely. And who do you think this slow pace benefits more, Andrew?
Absolutely, this benefits Tyson Dukes. He's the wrestling machine. Will White, he wants to get high flying, he wants to splash, he wants to jump around, but if Dukes can hold him down, oh no. If Dukes can hold him down, wear him down, I think it's in his favor, especially up 1-0.
That's right. When Will White gets the adrenaline flowing. He moves very quickly in the ring. Doesn't even give his opponents a chance to think. And maybe that's where Bill Black comes into play. Oh, and he went for the chop, and he ducked. Will White ducked out of that. And now he's taking advantage of this one.
reversal. Brings Will White
down.
Will White to the mat, working on that arm. What's Dukes thinking about here? Keeping him in the center of the ring.
And now he's got White's arm.
Oh.
Look at him wrenching that back.
Very slow and methodical pace from Tyson Dukes. Working that arm and just the pain that I can only imagine is shooting into the shoulder of Will White.
But look at him, he's still getting to his feet. The crowd's willing him on.
Headbutts to the midsection here from Will White trying to fight back. He's trying to get back into this one. Brings Tyson Dukes down to the mat, into the headlock.
Nice reversal from Dukes.
Once again, goes for that arm bar. Oh, he's driving his left hand into that shoulder, and now his knee. And he's really going to work.
Well, one thing's for sure, these two seem to have each other very well scouted.
Absolutely. But I agree with you with the slow pace that really benefits Tyson Dukes in this match. Giving him the advantage to get out of these holds.
Solid right hand.
Wow. Quick forearm brings Will White into the corner. And now here come the knife edge chops. Oh, very painful. Knocking the wind out of Will White. Another huge forearm.
Now we've gone from technical wrestling. Now we're brawling.
Tyson Dukes is a well-rounded wrestler, as is Will White. These two are very well matched in the ring. Once again, going to work on the arm of Will White. He could break his shoulder right here. Pop it right out of the socket.
But the thing is, I don't think he'll tap out.
He's crazy enough to just not give up. He definitely has that never give up attitude, as we've seen over the last year here in PWE. Now he pushes Tyson Dukes into the corner, and now he's starting to fight back.
There's that splash.
Oh, here's that splash into the corner. Corner to corner, here we go.
Going for it again.
And this is Will White's pace. This is where he likes to keep the match at. He's starting to fight back. Oh, and a huge Blue Thunder Bomb goes for the cover. And that's it. Blue Thunder Bomb ends the second pin of this 2 out of 3 falls match. And we're all tied up at one, folks.
And just as we said, right when business picked up, right when the pace turned on, Will White takes advantage, makes it 1-1.
Very quickly, Will White got back into this match. And here he goes. With a huge scoop slam into the center of the ring. And now he's taunting to the crowd. He's telling everybody he's gonna fly. And we've seen this from Will White a number of times. A little swanton bomb action as Will White goes up to the top.
This is not good for Tyson.
Absolutely not. This third and final fall could end quickly. Oh, and Tyson Dukes manages to roll out of harm's way.
He felt it coming.
Well, he has his opponent well scouted. He knows. He's seen Will White do that move once or twice here in PWE. And now the action is spilling to the outside. And what's Tyson Dukes thinking here? Going to get a little more violent in this third round. Oh, and into the steel barricade, the unforgiving steel. The back of Will White being driven off that barricade. And now Tyson Dukes taking some time.
Tyson Dukes going all out now. This is next fall wins.
Doesn't like that sign from our resident sign guy in here at PWE. Not a Tyson Dukes fan, apparently. Everybody here in Oshawa seems to be Will White fans. They seem very happy now that Will White is fighting back into this. And now it's Tyson Dukes who goes out the steel barricade. Jamie Virtue in the front row once again, not liking that. Will White rolls into the ring, breaking up that 10 count. Very smart. dive in the face of Tyson Dukes off the ring apron. What's Will White thinking here? Once again into that steel barricade.
Back first, we have seen it all in this matchup.
Watch your knees, fans. And that's what happens when you're here in the Oshawa Legion Hall at PWE. You almost become part of the action. You're so close to it.
Up close and personal.
And we have a packed house here tonight for this amazing 2 out of 3 falls match between two of PWE's top guys. Oh! And Will White just driving Tyson Dukes' chest off the top of that barricade and once again breaking up the 10 count so that the action could stay here on the outside.
Will White, he's wanted this for a while. Tyson Dukes fighting back. Will White, he wants to inflict pain on Tyson Dukes.
Well, it wasn't done there, but Tyson Dukes is fighting back now. And here come the chops once again, chirping with the crowd. Oh, and the crowd in the front row doesn't seem to like this.
They gotta show some respect.
Oh, while Tyson Dukes was taking his time to yell at the fans, Will White managed to catch his breath and fight his way back into this one.
The crowd, they're cheating for Will White. They're distracting Tyson Dukes. How's that fair?
Crowd is definitely on Will White's side here in the Oshawa Legion Hall, as we've seen time after time. White is telling the ref to hold Tyson Dukes back, give him a chance to get back into this match. And now the action is spilled back into the ring. Finally, this match can continue. Pinfall will not count on the outside. The third and final fall will have to be decided in the center of the ring. Tyson Dukes in control of this match once again. He seemed to have dominated quite a bit with the early pinfall and the first round, early on in the match.
Will White, he looks a little bit dazed right now.
Absolutely. Well, Tyson Dukes just squeezing the midsection of Will White, driving the breath out of him. That's really gonna slow Will White down in this match. And he needs to fight back with elbows. It's the only way to get out of that hold.
Tyson Dukes trying to get back to the game plan of wearing down Will White, but White is always fighting back.
Will White is almost a bit of an underdog here, especially in a match like this, where Tyson Dukes has so much in-ring experience. He's been doing this for a very long time. That's why they call him the wrestling machine. Crowd chanting, let him out, because they know once that happens, there might be no stopping Will White or Bill Black. That's exactly where Will White gets his advantage. He gets a burst of energy, and he just explodes back into a match. As you saw when he dominated and got that second pinfall here in the match. Tie this one up 1-1. One pinfall apiece.
Look at this back and forth fight.
Well, who will prevail? And into the corner. Tyson Dukes dominating once again. Couple of uppercuts here. Will White is dazed and confused.
Tyson Dukes is in full control late in this matchup.
Well, he's had full control for a very long time in this matchup.
Will White, he's out on his feet. He's hanging on for dear life.
Oh, and he drops to one knee, drops to both knees. Will White is almost out of it. Tyson Dukes very confident now, as he should be. Crowd chanting Bill Black. We've yet to see him here in this match. Will we see him? Will that turn the tide here?
I don't think we will at this point. Tyson Dukes, he's got this one.
Well, he's got Will White up on the top turnbuckle. What's he thinking about here?
He's looking to end it right here, Sal. That's what he's going to do.
Well, this could very well be it right now. Will White is certainly out of it. Tyson Dukes chanting Tyson sucks. He's about to prove them all wrong. Going up to the top. What are we about to see? Tyson Dukes. Going to hook the arm. Could we see a superplex right here? This could end it all. Will White with punches.
Wait, he's fighting back.
Slowly starting to fight his way back into this one. And the third fall is yet to be determined. Next fall wins it. We're in sudden death mode, folks.
Will White, Tyson Dukes, they're brawling on the top.
Exchanging punches on the top turnbuckle. This could be very dangerous.
Oh, solid shot to the face.
Oh, and Will White is going nuts. And I think Tyson Dukes may be out of it. That was a flurry of punches. And what's he going for? Falls to the mat. And this could be it. Swanton bomb from Will White.
He hit
going
it.
For the cover. And this one's over. Will White gets the third and final pinfall in an amazing 2 out of 3 falls match.
I can't believe it. What a comeback for Will White. Tyson Dukes had it.
What a match we witnessed here in PWE. That one is going to go down as an instant classic. Between these two, who are truly at the top of their game. Excellent 2 out of 3 falls action, and Will White prevails as the better man.
And look at him, Will White still in pain. Tyson Dukes wore him down, but somehow Will White with the victory.
Well, Will White didn't get a whole heck of a lot of offense in this one, but he did when it counted. He managed to get 2 pinfalls over that man, the wrestling machine, Tyson Dukes. Who isn't too happy with this?
Absolutely not. He can't be pleased with himself after this one.
Well, right now, we have to throw it backstage to Joshua James, who has a rebuttal for Cody Diener.
Cody Diener, you call yourself the king of the Schwa. I've seen Oshawa. That doesn't hold a lot of weight around here. Nothing but a bunch of dirty scumbags who collect their welfare checks. Now tonight, I'm gonna prove to everybody here in the Schwa that I should be crowned the king. Not that I want the title. I don't want that title. I want the PWE title. And you are a stepping stone. You are a minor stepping stone for me to get that gold around my waist. We're both former PWE champions, and tonight, I'll be the fan favorite.
Will Joshua James be the fan favorite? Well, I'll tell you one man who's certainly not a fan favorite here, and he has graced us with his presence once again, RJ City. Very charismatic wrestler, and he's about to go in to the ring for some one-on-one action here.
He might not be a fan favorite, but he's a favorite of mine, I'll tell you that.
And another sign from Sign Guy that he doesn't like, and this match is coming up. Stay with us.
All right, we're back, and here's Space Monkey making his way to the ring. He's going to face RJ City. Can't believe we have a Space Monkey in PWE.
Well, the fans seem to love him. Look, he's got his own sign. High fives all around. Space Monkey has landed here in PWE once again. What does he have in store for us here tonight? We're about to find out.
The guy thinks he's a monkey from space.
Maybe he is a monkey from space. Do any of us really know? And look at that, even streamers.
There's a real professional, RJ City. He's none too happy with this Space Monkey.
RJ City's holding a microphone because he had some words for the crowd during the break.
He's not impressed.
Get your stinking paws off me, you damn dirty ape.
And what a line from RJ City. He is the man who puts entertainment back in sports entertainment. quite the movie buff. RJ City not impressed with his opponent here tonight. Space Monkey. Space Monkey was about to eat a banana before the match started. He needs potassium.
Why has he even got a banana out there? It's a wrestling match.
He's a monkey. He wanted to get some energy before the match started. RJ City telling him to give him the banana.
Give me the banana. Give it to him.
Oh, he's not going to give it up that easily. RJ City isn't happy. Oh, he tossed the banana. He's pointing over there. What? Oh, and the ref seemed to have caught it. Now he's throwing it back to Space Monkey. A little monkey in the middle here going on.
I thought the ref was supposed to be impartial. What's going on here?
RJ City was monkey in the middle there. And he's not happy being embarrassed by Space Monkey. And this match started. Space Monkey off the ropes. He hooks the arms. Looking up. Oh, and a huge drop kick from Space Monkey with the distraction.
The banana distraction.
Here he goes. He was going for that signature monkey flip. RJ City sent him up onto the top turnbuckle. Here goes Space Monkey. The flying Hurricanrana. And that's the high-flying style you'll see from Space Monkey here at PWE. Shoulder into the corner of RJ City. And here's the quick pace of Space Monkey. Oh, and RJ City. Wow. What a springboard backdrop. And RJ City is in control.
He's gonna send his monkey back to space.
Well, only got a one count on that one. RJ City isn't too happy with that. Space Monkey's face into the corner. RJ City stomping a mud hole.
And you'd think that a top star like RJ City,
oh, and he's got him by the tail,
would be facing someone better than a monkey.
He's got it wrapped around the middle rope.
Or maybe he is a monkey, he's got a tail.
Is that even painful? I don't know. I don't really know. But the crowd seems to be behind Space Monkey here, the monkey chants. And if you're behind this match, or any of the action here tonight, you can follow us on Twitter at RogersTVPWE. Give us the hashtag RJ versus Monkey.
While you're at it, follow RJ City on Twitter. He's got some amazing Twitter game.
Well, he is a superstar. Online and in the ring and on TV, everywhere this guy goes. RJ is money.
In control of Space Monkey, and now he's mocking him.
Crowd doesn't seem too happy with that, but I don't think RJ City really cares. He is in control of this match. Space Monkey can't get back to his feet. RJ City, oh, and a huge knee to the face. Blowing kisses to the fans here at the Oshawa Legion Hall. I don't think they're too happy with that.
They don't appreciate someone like RJ City here.
Oh, double axe handle from the top. Now RJ City is stopping to take some time to talk to the ref.
Yeah, he's probably still mad the ref was playing monkey in the middle.
Well, he was a little embarrassed.
Where's his helmet?
Oh, he's asking for the helmet. What's he thinking of doing? RJ City has the banana.
He's got the banana.
He's having a little treat. Oh!
He spits it on his favorite fan in Oshawa.
Absolutely, RJ's favorite fan there in the front row.
And now he's got the helmet.
He's got the helmet in the corner. What's he thinking here? Space Monkey trying to fight back. No! A chop to the throat. RJ saying he's the smarter of the two. And what's he thinking about here? Gonna charge him in the next corner. Giving his signature taunt. Oh!
There it is.
Looking like he was going for a splash. Gave him a disrespectful slap across the face. And that's how RJ City rolls. Space Monkey has the helmet. I don't know if RJ City sees that. Yes, he does. Oh, and a drop kick with the helmet. And RJ City is taken down to the mat. And Space Monkey could very well be back in this one. And the ref is starting to count to 10. He's up to 3. Who's going to get to their feet first?
I thought RJ City may have been knocked out, but it looks like he's still with it.
Well, RJ City being taken down by the huge drop kick from Space Monkey with the assist from the helmet.
Here comes RJ.
Oh, and a huge kick. RJ's stumbling.
It's another blow to the head. This isn't
What's
good.
What's Space Monkey going to do? And a huge flying forearm from Space Monkey. Going for the cover. This could be it. No, and RJ City manages to kick out at 2.
It's going to take a lot more to keep down RJ City.
And a headbutt from Space Monkey. Irish whip to the other side. Oh, no. What is RJ City going for here? Wow. And what a extended crab here. He's got him elevated.
Incredible from RJ City. Oh, no, Space Monkey.
Monkey with the roll-up. No, RJ City managed to kick out. And a huge kick to the face. And now RJ City looks like he may be out of it.
He's taking a lot of blows to the head in this match. This isn't good.
And Space Monkey's going up. He's climbing to space. Crowd's chanting Monkey. They're really behind Space Monkey in this match. What's going to happen? No. RJ City, smarter of the two, hits that top rope and takes Space Monkey down. Monkey's in a lot of pain here on the top turnbuckle, and RJ City's ready to go back to work. RJ City just stating that he's leaving the Planet of the Apes. Maybe he's going to go back to Planet Hollywood. That's where RJ City belongs. Oh, and Space Monkey, was he biting the forehead of RJ City?
Can't let a monkey bite you in a match.
What's he going for here? Huge tornado DDT. Wow, just driving the face off the mat and going for the cover. This could be it. No, RJ City somehow managed to kick out of that one. Space Monkey can't believe it, and neither can I.
He's going to have to check himself for rabies or something.
Maybe Ebola. Oh, and what's he going for here? Another springboard
backdrop. Oh, reverse.
No. The Space Monkey reverses it. And he almost had the three count there.
Thank God.
And here it is, that signature monkey flip from Space Monkey. Could this be it? Space Monkey going up top once again. Oh, and a huge moonsault, but RJ City got out of the way. Kip up from Space Monkey. RJ City with that knee, and this could be it for Space Monkey, and it is. RJ City manages to win this one.
The winner of the match, RJ City.
Well, a well-fought match from Space Monkey. But RJ City is the one who gets the victory. That huge knee.
Of course he was gonna win. He's RJ City, for God's sake.
RJ City certainly making a name for himself here in PWE. He's done a good job of that the last few months. RJ City gets the victory, but right now we have to go backstage to All Ego, Ethan Page.
I've been asked my thoughts about my title match tonight against Tyler Turbo. I got a couple thoughts, to be honest. One of them is the fact that every time he comes out, he's wearing this robe. And on the back of the robe, it says, Saturday Night Delight. Yet the event is at 2 p.m. on a freaking Sunday. So your t-shirt actually makes a lot of sense. You're pretty stupid. Now, you're actually really stupid because you've aligned yourself with the most annoying human being I've met, not just in wrestling, but in the whole planet, Adam Hayes. And this guy is causing so much fuss in everyone's lives in Pro Wrestling Eclipse, that tonight I've found a nice way of avoiding having him involved in any facet of the main event.
he's going to be handcuffed to a guardrail while Ethan Page punches the living crap out of the Saturday Night Delight, Tyler Tirva. And Ethan Page becomes the first ever two-time Eclipse champion. And that ain't confidence. No. It's all ego.
And all ego's going to have his shot at Tyler Tirva once again in our main event for the PWE Fusion Championship. Stay with us. Gonna be a slugfest, folks. Cody Deaner going to work right away. He's enraged. Absolutely. Quickly exploding into this match. Taking out Josh James.
This is his night of payback. This match could be over quick.
Very well, maybe. Crowd's calling for a DDT. But who knows? Maybe Cody Deaner wants to take his time. Teach Joshua James a bit of a lesson first. Or not. He's calling for the DDT. My bad.
This could be it.
Going for the DDT, had it locked in, but no, Joshua James manages to escape.
Very smart move from the PWE veteran.
Absolutely. He knows Cody Deaner. He knows what he's all about. These two have been in the ring a number of times together.
He knows that DDT
City's biggest fan. Cody Deaner doesn't miss an opportunity to high-five his fans. That's why he is the king of the schwa. He is royalty here in Oshawa, that's for sure.
I think he invites everybody here to the Deaner Dynasty Estates after every event.
He may be celebrating after today. Or not. Knee to the face from Josh James. Doesn't allow Cody Deaner to get back into the ring. Oh! Josh James called for quiet there amongst the fans. We heard that forearm hit the back of Cody Deaner. And now Joshua James is starting to get back into this one.
He's finally able to show that mean streak that we've been seeing over the last few months from Joshua.
As I've been saying, this one is very personal between these two. This is an all-out brawl. Josh James goes for the cover now. Tried to end it there, but Cody Deaner kicked out after two.
Joshua James has a lot to prove in this match as well. He was once on top here in PWE. He's just been lingering around for a while. He needs to make his mark here against such a big name like Cody Deaner.
Absolutely. And don't get Joshua James wrong. He has had some high-profile matches, rather, over the last few months. But he's been clawing and scratching to get his way back to the top here in PWE. And a big win over Cody Deaner tonight. That may just put him next in line. At a shot for the PWE Fusion Championship.
Reversal from James. Nice elbow.
Oh, and Cody Deaner goes flying out of the ring and down to the outside. Joshua James taking some time to show that he's the superior man. And Joshua James had no real motive to take out Cody Deaner a few months ago.
I think he's just trying to make a name for himself.
Absolutely. Just trying to get his name back on the map here in PWE. And it certainly worked.
Smart to target the fan favorite here in Oshawa, one of the biggest names, one of the top dogs here in PWE, Cody Deaner.
Well, now he's certainly on Cody Deaner's radar. That's for sure.
Deaner looks like he's in some pain.
Joshua James has done a fair amount of damage here. Cody Deaner. Fans are getting him back into this one.
Joshua James was definitely wrong about one thing earlier on tonight when he said he would be the fan favorite. That certainly is not true.
I don't know if that's a title that you can take away from Cody Deaner here in Oshawa. But he may be able to walk away with a victory here. Cody Deaner was starting to gain some momentum, and Joshua James had the answer. And here he goes in the camel clutch. He's gonna make him tap, I don't know. Oh! Took him down at the lower back. And now he's gonna try and lock in that camel clutch once again. Good strategy here from Joshua James. Cody Deaner could very well tap right here.
Aggression here from Joshua James. That's what he needs to focus on. Don't focus on the fans. You don't need the fans to like you to be champion. Just be aggressive in the ring.
Cody Deaner looks like he's out of it here. Once again, he's going to try and lock in that camel clutch. Joshua James looking for his accolades here tonight. Is he going to tap out? I don't know. Could he do it?
Deaner's trying to feed off the crowd.
Oh! And Cody Deaner had that one scouted. And that can't feel too good for Joshua James right now. And Cody Deaner, just like that, is back into this one.
I feel like that may have been a little bit of a low blow, ref.
Absolutely, but Cody Deaner doing what it takes to get back into this one. And a huge clothesline. And just like that, Cody Deaner is back, and he's fired up and ready for a DDT on Joshua James. Are we going to Could this be it? He's calling for it. Look out behind you, Josh. Oh, and once again, Josh James rolls out of the ring.
Second time, the veteran getting out of harm's way. Josh. And not this time.
Joshua James has been studying the tapes. He's been watching PWE here on Rogers TV week after week. He knows the deal with Cody Deaner.
Deaner from out of nowhere. Taking down James.
And he's going for a DDT on the outside. The unforgiving hardwood floor of the Oshawa Legion here.
If that happens, good night, Joshua.
He's going to knock out Joshua James cold. What is he thinking? This man's a maniac. Oh! Joshua James drives him into the corner. And Jamie Virtue. He's thinking about something here. He's got that cane in hand. What's he going to do? Oh! And a cane to the back. And that seemed to have no effect. Oh, no. He's going to be part of the action now.
Oh, no. Dieter, you can't grab a fan like that.
He's not a fan. He's been working with Josh James all along. Can't you tell? And now he's going to get what's coming to him. And this match ends in disqualification. Finally, the ref comes to his senses. And now Cody Deaner is gonna hit Jamie Virtue with the cane.
He bought a ticket, he's a
wait,
fan,
wait, wait,
you can't
wait. What's
hit
going
him?
On here? What's going on? Seems to be distracted.
Ladies and gentlemen, Cody Deaner
oh,
has
finally
been
realizes.
Counted out. Therefore,
Deaner's been counted out, wasn't it? Disqualification, he's counted out.
Joshua James.
Joshua James wins via countout.
What a huge win for Joshua James.
Oh, my. Joshua James managed to get the victory. Not necessarily a clean victory over Cody Deaner, but a victory nonetheless.
Although Deaner's fault, he got distracted.
And it looks like Josh James and Jamie Virtue are working together, but right now we have to go backstage.
Chapter 4. Ethan Page loses to Tyler Tirva again. It's unfortunate that tonight the commissioner, Adam Hayes, is going to have to be handcuffed to the guardrail at ringside. But at the same time, he's also going to be front and center when Tyler Tirva defeats Ethan Page 1-2-3. I'm the dapper. I'm the dimpled. I'm the dangerously delicious Mr. Young, Fit, and Stupid Pretty. I'm the Saturday Night Delight, the Sunday Morning Hangover Cure, Tyler Tirva. And after tonight, I'm still going to be your Fusion Champion.
Well, that's later on, but coming up next, Last Man Standing, Rage and Amato. Shirt on outside, and now he has a jacket on inside.
Well, that's just how Jesse Amato works. He doesn't play by the rules of society. As you can tell, just by looking at him. He's got a couple of folding chairs. What else is in there? Broomsticks, everything.
Did you bring this stuff with him everywhere?
Is that a box of Lego?
Well, he's ready for the Last Man Standing match. He's gonna need all those toys. He's gonna need all the help he can. He's got rage tonight.
Well, he's been kicking on rage here for the last few months.
Introducing his opponent, about to make his way ringside from Toronto, Ontario. He weighs in at 280 pounds. He is the supernova of superstars. The Tyrannosaurus Flex, the genetic freak with mountain-sized peaks. He is the man they call Rage.
versus a maniac in this match.
Well, this one is not going to be pretty, folks. I can guarantee that. Oh, he's whipping him with a fan-made belt.
Are they going outside?
What is happening here?
Oh, back of the head up against the wall.
And now they're spilling into the crowd. The crowd are definitely getting their money's worth here tonight. Oh, now Rage is the one who's being thrown into the wall.
They're going to destroy the Legion.
Legion's going to fall apart thanks to these two. They don't care. It's getting a little crazy here. Camera guy's doing his best to follow the action here. There it is. They're out by the merch table. Signing some autographs during the match, maybe. I don't know. Where are these two going to end up? Anything goes in last man standing. We'll certainly do our best to try and follow the action here.
This is insane.
It definitely is. And I'm sure the fans are loving this right now. Up close and personal.
Oh, are they coming back?
Here they come down the middle aisle, ready to go back to the ring. Amato thrown into that barricade. What is happening here? Barricades come loose. Face first off the steel barricade. Oh, Rage is just tossing him around like a rag doll. There's a definite size difference between the two.
There goes Amato.
Oh,
flying over the barricade.
But I don't think the size difference really seems to matter to Jesse Amato. Welcome to Rage Town.
Oh!
Maybe not. Welcome to the Amato Asylum.
And those are the great equalizers in this match. All those toys that Jesse Amato brought.
He's definitely got a bunch of traps set up.
Oh, and he's gonna grab the table.
This is a fan favorite right here. Tables being set up and a ring full of goodies. Jesse Amato has a whole bunch of traps set up, not unlike Home Alone. And now what's gonna happen with the table here? He's pulling the barricade closer. I think Jesse Amato's got some crazy thoughts in that head of his.
He's always got crazy thoughts. But if you want to take out Rage, this might be a good idea.
Well, that's the name of the game. It's last man standing. You have to keep your opponent down on his back for 10 seconds. And it takes a lot to take the big man Rage down. That's for sure.
He's got the table set up. Some creativity from Jesse Amato.
Well, whatever Jesse Amato has in mind here, I'm telling you, it's not going to be pretty, folks.
Uh-oh, it could backfire.
Oh, no. Rage is going to drive him through that table. No. Oh, Jesse Amato manages to get out of that one. Oh, and Rage goes face first off that table.
Jesse Amato's blowing bubbles.
Yeah, bubbles. What is this going to do? He's drinking the bubbles. Oh, into the eyes of Rage. That has to sting. That's just how crazy Jesse Amato is.
That can't be safe, drinking bubbles.
I don't think he cares. This man will go to whatever length it takes to take his opponent down.
Now Rage might be blinded.
Tennis, anyone? Here we go. What else has he got here? Here's that bucket. Here's a bucket of Lego. Maybe he's going to build a weapon to beat Rage down with. I don't know.
Into the corner, into that chair.
Oh, and he wedged the chair into the corner there. Smart move by Jesse Amato, and a clothesline to the back of the neck. Now he gave him a kick to the face. And let's not forget that table is still hanging there at ringside. And now here goes the garbage pail.
I think it's recycling.
Oh. Well, whatever you want to call it. I'm sure Rage is calling it pain right now. Is that a rake?
a rake. So Amato, he recycles, he keeps his yard clean.
Oh, and he's literally giving him a back rake. And this is where Amato's comfortable. This is just his style. He is known for this hardcore, crazy style of wrestling, putting your body on the line, doing whatever it takes to win a match. And he is certainly going to do that tonight. Amato doesn't care.
And I can't believe that it's working. I thought Rage was going to run away with this matchup.
And this little contraption doesn't look pretty right here. Oh, and Rage has
Uh-oh.
Him up. Oh, no. This could backfire once again. Oh! Oh, and Jesse Amato sent through those two chairs. Those two folding chairs in the center of the ring.
One of them's bent and destroyed. Tide has turned here. Rage is in full control now after that.
Well, Rage didn't bring any weapons down to the ring.
So many blows to the head. Jesse Amato, how is he taking it? Jesse Amato crawling around. The referee is counting. He's got the broom.
And Amato had the broom.
And it backfired again.
You think Amato regrets bringing all these weapons to the ring now?
I think he does now. He's writhing in pain.
Almost each and every one has backfired on him. Now he's being choked out by the broom. Is that a plunger in the corner there? What kind of stuff did Amato come to play with here? A potted plant as well. And now Rage. Those big boots in the corner. Crowd still chanting for Jesse Amato. They like this hardcore, crazy style.
And that's the one thing about Jesse Amato, though. He can take a lot of pain and stay in a match.
Well, that's certainly what he's known for. The man is wild. The man is unorthodox. The man breaks into our TV production truck and gets his videos on air. Does whatever it takes to get known and whatever it takes to win a match.
Off the ropes.
Oh, and there's that flying shoulder from Rage. And is that going to be it? We've seen that move take out a number of opponents here.
Rage is just bigger and stronger than everybody.
And once again, going for the second meltdown. Taking out Jesse Amato, and Amato's tangled up on the ropes, and he looks out of it. This could be it right here. Rage is going to do a little bit of light reading. And the ref is at a count of three, and this could be it for the 10 count. What you got there, Rage? Anything interesting?
I didn't know Rage was a reader.
Apparently so. And he's got to look out behind him because Jesse Amato's getting back to his feet. No, the 10 count's not going to happen here. A magazine or high school yearbook? What is that?
I don't know. Either way, it distracted Rage.
Well, just enough for Jesse Amato to take it and use it as a weapon. And now Rage is tied up in the corner. And Jesse Amato looking around at all the weapons he brought here to play.
There's the pot.
Is that a clay pot? Oh, no. Oh, I don't like this. And I don't think Rage is going to like it much either. Jesse Amato, what are you thinking? What is going on through that crazy head of yours? He's got that signature wrench. Oh! And we heard that. We heard the noise of that potted plant breaking thanks to that wrench. And that's all we need to say. We know what happened there, folks. And if you thought this was going to be a light and fun match, you thought wrong. You better put the kids to bed for this one.
This is absolute chaos.
It looks like he's opening up that box of Lego. Gonna build another weapon here. one may have hit him in the eye. Well, that could certainly do some damage. He's going for a clean sweep now. Gonna sweep him right out of the ring. Clean up the mess he made. The midsection. Oh, he broke that broom handle on Rage's back. Now he's going for the chair. Gonna break the chair on Rage's back. Another already broken chair. Oh, man.
I think Amato lost it.
Amato certainly lost it, but he's doing whatever it takes to take this big man down. Now he's going with the rake once again. Oh, man.
You heard that shatter. Does he have a kitchen sink?
Oh. Well, I don't know if he brought one to the ring in that container, but he certainly brought a lot to the ring. And Rage may be finally down for the 10 count on this one.
Rage isn't moving. This could be it. Oh, no, there he is. The big man's getting up.
What is it gonna take Rage down for the 10 count? I think Jesse Amato's starting to wonder the same thing.
All right, Amato's bringing him to the apron.
Oh, I don't know.
That table he set up earlier.
Amato's got some sick thoughts in mind. What's going to happen here? Oh, no, could this backfire? And it does. Jesse Amato goes through the table. And that has to be it. Jesse Amato just went crashing through that table to the outside. And the ref is starting his count. At a count of four.
I think Amato's dead, but he's getting
no.
up.
What is going on here?
Right when you think he's down and out, he gets right back up. He's such
a
maniac.
I can't believe this is happening. These men are crazy. And it looks like the rake has done damage to Rage's back. And I don't know what damage it's going to take these men out. But Jesse Amato got back into the ring. And the 10 count has to start over at one.
Sometimes you just gotta know when to stay down.
Oh, and Rage, he has that wrench, that signature wrench. Oh, and a huge wrench to the back once again, driving that wrench into the back of Jesse Amato. And I think Rage is wondering maybe what it's gonna take to keep Jesse Amato down.
That wrench, Jesse Amato's used that wrench on so many wrestlers here in PWE.
Rage has Jesse Amato up. Could he finally take him out once and for all? We're about to find out.
I think he's seeing red.
Oh, and a huge pile driver from Rage. This has to be it. And the count is going to start over right now.
All right, now I think Jesse Amato's dead.
Well, I don't blame Jesse Amato if he just decides to stay down in this one. If he's even conscious enough to get back to his feet. And we're at a count of five, and this one could be it. This could definitely do it here.
Some in the crowd are trying to will him to his feet.
We're at seven. And the amount of pain that Jesse Amato went through, we're at nine. This could be it.
I don't think so.
Ray manages to pull this one off and get a victory over that crazy maniac known as Jesse Amato.
What an insane last man standing match. Amato gave it his all.
We saw tables, we saw chairs, we saw Lego, we saw it all in this one. And what's Rage thinking about here?
We get back! Well, you know what? You're pretty tough, buddy. You just took an ass kicking.
And now a little sign of respect here from Rage. Saying he took a beating from Rage. And he's giving him the respect for all that these two men have gone through here tonight in this match. Oh no.
that to the commissioner.
He just did it. He doesn't care. He has no respect for authority around here. And that's it.
You just remember one thing. I am Jesse Amato. And nobody, and I mean nobody, does what I do quite like me.
And he proved that here tonight.
Severe beating that he got, Jesse Amato is still standing, and the crowd respects him for that.
But he took out the commission. There's going to be repercussions for that.
So we'll just have to wait and see. But up next, our main event.
Well, we're back, and it is time for the main event, and here comes All Ego Ethan Page.
Well, All Ego Ethan Page has some unfinished business, as last time here, he had a title shot against Tyler Tirva. He won the Frenzy Rumble in order to get that title shot, and there was a bit of interference from Commissioner Adam Hayes. So last time here on PWE, Dr. Mask announced that he would get his rematch. And Ethan Page chose as a stipulation that Adam Hayes had to be handcuffed to the guardrail so there would be no interference allowed. Crowd's calling for a new champ. All Ego Ethan Page. Will they get it here tonight? I guess we'll have to wait and find out.
From your girlfriend's dreams and weighs in at 213 pounds. He is your current reigning and defending Pro Wrestling Eclipse Fusion Champion. Give it up for the Saturday Night Delight, Tyler Tirva!
Here he is, the Saturday Night Delight, the PWE reigning, defending Fusion Champion, Tyler Tirva.
There's the trophy, there's the belt, and there's the man here in PWE.
Well, the man that makes matches here in PWE is out here with the champion, but he's not going to be allowed to walk around the ring much longer. He's about to be handcuffed to the guardrail.
Got it all. He's got the looks, he's got the ability, and he's got the establishment behind him.
Well, he certainly does, as it's been proven here in the last few months, as Adam Hayes has gotten involved in almost all of his championship matches. But not tonight.
Longtime champ here in PWE. Could be the best we've ever had.
He's coming from a long line of great PWE champions. Got Joshua James, Cody Diener, Will White, all former champions. All Ego Ethan Page himself as well. And he's been looking for some time to get that title back. And that's what it's all about, folks. Hashtag PWE Fusion Championship. And Ethan Page is making sure that they don't forget the stipulation that he called for. A bit of audio issues here tonight.
I'm gonna use a way better mic, okay?
Okay.
Listen here, Tyler Tirva! Something happened last show where Ethan Page got a stick.
making it happen. And there it is. Adam Hayes is locked in place. And there's Tyler Tirva taking advantage of the situation. All ego Ethan Page taking his mind, taking his eyes off the champ. Oh, and a huge back rake from the champion. Well, he's certainly a fighting champion. And now he doesn't have the help of the commissioner for this one. So let's see how well the champion fares now.
Tyler Tirva doesn't need the help of the commissioner. He can do it all on his own.
Well, he's going to have to prove it here tonight. Bionic elbow there. Gift for the fans, but no. Looks like All Ego is re-gifting. Sends the champ back into the ring. That's where the action has to stay.
What a huge match this is. To the top stars.
Never mind. Ethan Page said he's going to send him right back in.
And look at this star.
Skin the cat. Tyler Tirva shades of Shawn Michaels there. Ego answers with some punches in the corner, twisting the arm there, corner to corner, reversal from the champ. Oh, and an elbow to the face of the champion. Off the ropes comes Ethan Page and a drop kick, going for the cover. Tyler Tirva kicks out.
And we'll definitely see some aggression here from All Ego Ethan Page after getting what he said he was screwed last time out of the title.
And there's the commissioner trying to break free of the handcuffs. I don't think that's gonna happen. And there's Adam Hayes' champion being dominated by All Ego Ethan Page. And the champion could be in trouble here tonight without the help of the commissioner. And Adam Hayes has no choice but to watch it all go down.
Page thought he was screwed last time, but I mean, it is what it is. He had his shot and he blew it. He's lucky to even get the rematch here tonight.
He had Tyler Tirva beat, and it was no thanks to the commissioner that he lost the match. So now tonight, he did the right thing and took the commissioner out of the equation. Looks like it's working in his favor. Dropping the knee to Tyler Tirva. Tyler Tirva manages to kick out after two. Ethan Page once again throwing Tyler Tirva to the outside. Calling for him to get up. What's Ethan Page going for here?
The champ's in trouble.
Said he's gonna fly. Here he goes. All Ego off the ropes.
Tyler Tirva
back in the ring. And a drop kick to the knee to take down All Ego Ethan Page. And Tyler Tirva might be back in this one.
What quickness by the champion. Tyler Tirva saw it coming.
Champion going to work on the knee. Don't forget, folks, this is our main event for the evening. Hashtag PWE Fusion Championship. That's what it's all about.
One of the biggest main events we've ever had here in PWE.
Absolutely. Two of the biggest stars on the indie scene today. All Ego Ethan Page going one-on-one with Tyler Tirva, the PWE Fusion champion. Going to work on the knee of All Ego. And Commissioner Adam Hayes has no choice but to watch the action all unfold from ringside as he is handcuffed to the guardrail. He will not be getting involved in this one tonight.
And that's absolutely ridiculous that the commissioner's handcuffed.
Well, the commissioner has done his fair share of dirty work the past few months here, getting involved in all the title matches of Tyler Tirva's. And now Ethan Page has a fair shot to take back that title that he has not held for a number of years here in PWE.
Adam Hayes just knows that Tyler Turva is the greatest champion we've ever had, and he wants to keep it that way.
Well, he very well may be. But let's see how he does on his own.
Here we go, vintage Turva right here.
Telling the audience to get their cameras ready. Going for that stalling handstand splash.
Look at the strength and athleticism.
And you can't deny that, but All Ego Ethan Page outsmarts him and gets the knees up. Tyler Turva doesn't get the splash out on this one. And this gives All Ego Ethan Page a chance to get back into this match. Oh, and Adam Hayes, is dragging the barricade with him to the ring.
He can't take it anymore.
And what's going on? What is Dr. Mass doing? He's uncuffing him. Ah, he doesn't have the right keys. Maybe he does. Well, Adam Hayes thought he outsmarted the promoter here, Dr. Mass, and got out, just unhooked the barricade and was dragging it to the ring, and now he's going to the ring. No, what is Dr. Mass doing? He's handcuffing him to himself. He is gonna keep a close eye on the commissioner.
What is this?
Well, Dr. Mass is just making sure that this one is gonna go down fairly. And he's going to keep a very close eye on the commissioner, who likes to get involved in these matches.
He's treating the commissioner like he's in daycare, like he's a child.
Well, the action is getting back here in the ring as the two are exchanging punches, but Ethan Page is getting the better of Tyler Turva. Corner to corner, kick to the midsection, going for a huge suplex there in the center of the ring. And things are not looking good for the champion.
Champs in pain, lower back. What a suplex there by All Ego.
Oh! And a knee to the gut of Ethan Page. Tyler Turva saying this one's over. Oh, and a huge, huge big boot.
Oh, no.
Ethan Page, could this be it? New champion. No, Tyler Turva manages to kick out after two.
I thought that was it. What a massive boot from All Ego Ethan Page.
Ethan
Turva.
Ethan Page thought that was it as well.
Turva's still got some fight in him.
What a title match main event we have here. PWE on Rogers TV. And now this is it. He's going for the spinning Dwayne. But no, Tyler Turva
had it
elbows
scouted.
His way out of that one. And he's going for the Death Valley driver now. Could he put Ethan Page away? No. Once again, going for the suplex. Tyler Turva gets out of that one off the ropes. And the huge picture perfect drop kick.
Absolutely beautiful.
Going for the cover. This could be it. Tyler Turva can retain. No, and Ethan Page kicks out after two. And now Tyler Turva can't believe it.
That was 2 3/4.
He thought that was three. What a main event we have here. And in the corner, you can see Adam Hayes' foot. He's trying to get in the ring. He is not happy. Look how grumpy he looks.
Well, why would he be happy? This is outrageous.
Dr. Mask is making sure this one goes down fairly. He is making sure that Adam Hayes does not get involved as he has in the past few months. And we're finally going to get a clean title match here in PWE. And if Tyler Turva wins it, then he's going to win it fair and square. And there's nothing wrong with that.
Here he goes.
Send him up for the Death Valley driver once again. No.
Oh, the ref.
And Ethan Page pushes Tyler Turva right into the referee, and the ref is down. This is not going to be good for All Ego.
Spinning Dwayne.
Spinning Dwayne. This has to be it. Goes for the cover. Come on. New champion right here. The ref is out. The ref is out cold. Ethan Page would have had this match won. And what is Adam Hayes doing? What does he have up his sleeve?
What is that?
What's the powder? Oh. Got the powder into the commissioner's face.
And Mask fell hard.
What is going on here?
What is this guy?
He's got to learn how to throw a punch. Is that, that's one of Mask's bodyguards. He needs to hire some better bodyguards. What is he doing? Hayes has the key.
I think Mask is out.
Hayes has the key and he manages to get out of the handcuff. Hayes is a free man.
As he should be, the commissioner.
Ethan Page is not happy about this, but Adam Hayes doing a little victory dance. The man is free for the first time in this match.
He can't put put your hands on the commissioner like that. What are you doing,
like
Ethan Page?
All Ego Ethan Page is going to deal with this once and for all. Going for the punch. No. Oh! And he moves out of the way, and Tyler Tirva.
Oh, no.
Dropkick to the commissioner. And Ethan Page with the roll up, a new champion right here.
The ref's still down.
The referee is still down. And now all the officials are down. Dr. Mask, Adam Hayes.
This is mayhem.
The referee. Oh, and the low blow by the champion, Tyler Tirva, as the ref is starting to get back up.
It's
and
all
Tyler
fair.
Tirva goes for the cover. And that one is it.
Yes.
That's what does it.
The man, he is still the champ.
What a screwy finish to the main event.
The Saturday Night Delight.
No thanks to the commissioner. Plan B. He had the yanks up his sleeve, and he managed to get out of the handcuffs and get involved once again.
Tyler Tirva, he fought for his title, and he just capitalized on this situation.
Well, like it or not, Tyler Tirva is still the PWE Fusion Champion. And Adam Hayes is still out from that dropkick from his champion, Tyler Tirva.
What a chaotic main event, but Tyler Tirva remains champion.
Hold up there, Slim.
Slim, I feel like $1 million bucks. You might think you're Slim on me.
Everybody learns never to piss me off. And I'm sorry I used that word. It looks like I'm going to have to bring in some help to deal with Mr. Tirva. Many years ago, I did a program with another company in this building, and I befriended somebody, and later on we started our own company, and we promised we'd never talk about the other company. It's a big deal for me to bring him home. So, next match, May 22nd, Michael Elgin returns to look after you.
What a huge announcement from Dr. Mask. Big Mike, Michael Elgin has returned home from Japan. And he is going to face Tyler Tirva one-on-one.
That is unbelievable.
It's all going down next time. But for now, we leave you in the Oshawa Legion Hall. We'll see you next time.